Mr. Ilton?
Yes?
You are sole proprietor and owner of the Wizzo Chocolate Company?
I am.
Constable Parrott and I are from the Hygiene Squad.
Oh, yes.
And we'd like to have a word with you about your box of chocolates entitled the Wizzo Quality Assortment.
Ah, good, yes.
If I may begin at the beginning. First, there is the cherry fondue. Now, this is extremely nasty. But we can't prosecute you for that.
Agreed.
Next, we have number four, crunchy frog.
Yes.
Am I right in thinking there's a real frog in here?
Yes, a little one.
Is it cooked?
No.
What, a raw frog?
We use only the finest baby frogs, dew-picked and flown from Iraq, cleansed in the finest quality spring water, lightly killed, hand-sealed in a succulent Swiss quintuple-smooth, full-cream, treble milk chocolate envelope, and lovingly frosted with glucose.
That's as maybe, but it's still a frog.
What else would it be?
Well, don't even take the bones out.
If we took the bones out, it wouldn't be crunchy, would it?
Constable Parrott ate one of those. Yes.
Well, it says crunchy frog quite clearly.
Well, never mind that. We have to protect the public. People aren't going to think there's a real frog in chocolate. The superintendent thought it was an almond whirl. They're bound to think it's some kind of mock frog.
Mock frog? We use no artificial preservatives or additives of any kind.
Nevertheless, I advise you in future to replace the words crunchy frog with the legend crunchy, raw, unboned, real, dead frog if you want to avoid prosecution.
What about our sales?
I don't give a damn about your sales. We have to protect the public. Now, what was this one? Number five. It was number five, wasn't it? Number five, Ram's Bladder Cup. Now, what kind of confection is this?
We use choicest juicy chunks of fresh Cornish ram's bladder, emptied, steamed, flavored with sesame seeds, whipped into a fondue, and garnished with lark's vomit.
Lark's vomit?
Correct.
It doesn't say anything down here about lark's vomit.
Yes, it does. On the bottom of the box, after monosodium glutamate.
I hardly think this is good enough. It would be more appropriate if the box bore a big red label warning lark's vomit.
Our sales would plummet.
Well, why don't you move into more conventional areas of confectionery like praline or lime cream, a very popular flavour, I'm led to understand, or strawberry delight. I mean, what's this one? Cockroach cluster. Mm. And this, anthrax ripple. And what's this one? Spring surprise?
Oh, that's our speciality. Covered in darkest, velvety, smooth chocolate. When you pop it into your mouth, stainless steel bolts spring out and plunge straight through both cheeks.
If people pop a nice chocolate in their mouths, they don't expect to get their cheeks pierced. In any case, it is an inadequate description of the sweetmeat. I shall have to ask you to accompany me to the station.
It's a fair cop.
And don't talk to the audience. We'll be right back.